Hello guys, welcome back to MufasuCAD with Autocad to the modeling practice exercise number 29, how to make a combination range. And also don't forget to subscribe our channel. You can click here and click OK. Next, active a notification, checklist and save to get our new tutorials. Okay, we start now. Open your AutoCAD software and I will create a circle. In here with a radius 13, we create circle again with radius 10, and the last with a radius 8.5, and enter. Okay, you can create line start from the center point to the top, and create a line start from this point to the bottom one. You can rotate the last object. Okay, start from the center point with angle 15 and enter. I will use array command to array this line object with a polar center point in here. And for items 12, okay, you can close array. Use line command to connect start from this point, and then in here. Okay, we use array again to array these two lines object with the polar from the center point. Okay, and for items 12, you can close array. Okay, we create this 2D sketch and select this object, delete. Next, we create line start from the center point to the top 151. Okay, and I will copy this line object to the rect 6. You can create a circle with tangent TTR, tangent 10 radius. Click at this point and this point with a radius 60 and enter. Use a trim command to cut this circle object, and I will cut this line. Select this line and delete. Okay, we create a line object start from this point to the bottom 17 and to the rect 14, and you can connect at this point. Okay, create line object start from this point to the bottom 2 and connect to this point. Okay, I will create line start from this point to this point. Select this object and delete. You can rotate this object. Okay, start from this point with angle 15 and enter. Next, move this object to this point. Move again to the right here 2 and enter. Okay, we create this model. I will create a circle object. Okay, start from the center point with radius 10. Move this circle object to the right 5 and to the top 5. Okay, use UGS command. We create a UGS start from this point to this point and click at this point. Use line command to create line start from this point to the rect here 1, and I will create a RC object. Click at this point with end point to this point. Okay, and radius 23 and enter. Okay, use trim command to cut this circle object. Okay, cut in here and you can cut in here. I will create a circle with tangent. Okay, click at this point to this point with radius 30 and enter. Okay, you can trim again this circle object and trim in here. Use mirror to mirror this object. Okay, start from this point to the top and enter. Now I will change UGS into Word. Okay, next we mirror this object. Start from this point to the bottom. And then I will create a circle object with TR, tangent 10 radius. Click at this point to this point with radius 30 and enter. Okay, you can use a trim command to cut this circle, and I will cut in here. Okay, you can cut in here. Select this object and delete. We create a circle with a tangent. Click at this point to this point with radius 17 and enter. Okay, next you can trim this circle object. Okay, and enter to finish. The last we offset this object, you can tap offset with distance 2. Okay, select in here, we'll offset in here with distance 2. Okay, next use a trim command to cut the circle. We'll cut in here and we cut in here. Okay, we already create this combination range. If you want to give a dimension into this object, you can tap D, enter to open Dimension Style Manager and click Modify. I will use a primary unit 0.0 for precision, and text I will use a 3. Okay, and this one for arrows are 3, 1, 1, and lines in here 1. Okay, and then click okay, close. Now we give a dimension with a dim radius to create a dimension radius. Okay, in here. Okay, next for dimension radius in here. Okay, in here. Okay. And I will use dim lin command to create a dimension linear in here. Okay. 151. And you can use dim rotate command to correct dimension in this point. Okay, I will correct dimension rotate in here. You also can correct in here. Okay, click twice. And I will correct dimension linear at this point. 12 and in here 2. Okay, I think it's enough today for AutoCAD 2D modeling practice exercise number 29, how to make a combination range. If you have any question about this tutorial, you can comment below this video, and see you next time in AutoCAD 2D modeling practice exercise number 30.